Yo, peace. Yo, it's big deadlift day. No belts needed around here. We didn't even take pre today. Peace.
Thank you, Murphy, for that intro. That's my friend Mike. And we're doing a deadlift video today. And it's going to be very similar to my sumo deadlift video, except this is conventional. I'm working up to 500 again. But the difference with this one is that I'm not using a belt or lifting straps. So I did get a little bit stronger, and conventional has been feeling a lot more natural for me lately. So yeah, I was feeling good today, feeling confident in my strength. So I just decided to go for it, even though I didn't have a belt. And the reason I don't have a belt is just because we kept losing them. I had like three regular belts from Dick's Sporting Goods, which were all like $30. But I lost every single one of them, so whoever's using that now, I hope they're hitting some PRs. So I usually alternate between conventional and sumo every week, just to keep the movements on point. And some people would say that this hinders your ability to improve in one of the lifts, but I think that the best accessory movement, even though it's not an accessory movement for sumo deadlift, is the conventional deadlift, just because it works so many muscles. And this is my friend Noel going for a quick 335. I think his PR is 385, and he's only 16 years old. So that's pretty impressive. And this is Mike going for a 335 PR, and he gets it pretty smoothly. And then I move on to 455 for my last warm-up. It went up a little bit shaky, but it was still pretty easy. And thankfully, Noel came through with the chalk that day, so it was pretty easy for me to keep my grip on this 500. So now I'm just gonna let it play out. As you can see, that 500 was pretty difficult, and my legs were shaking, so I had to grind it out. And now I move on to the working sets that I did for that day, which was a 3x5 with 405. And what I did with this, actually, is with my mixed grip, I changed it so that my right hand was underneath as opposed to my left hand. So the reason I did this was because I've been doing mixed grip with my right hand over and my left hand under for a long time now. And I noticed that my left side of my back was getting more developed than my right side, and it was causing imbalances. So if you use the mixed grip, I advise that you do it both directions. It's gonna feel real awkward at first, but I've done it for the past couple weeks now, so I kind of gotten used to it. But I still pull my PRs with my left hand under. So that's about it for this video, and hope you guys enjoyed it. Like, subscribe, comment, do whatever. Peace.